Journalist Tom Ricks is a star, not for his new book, not for his 17 years at the Wall Street Journal, but for his 90 seconds on Fox News. When asked about the attacks on the U.S. consulate in Benghazi and claims the Obama administration whitewashed it, Ricks employed an Earth-to-Fox maneuver.
I've covered a lot of firefights. It's impossible to figure out what happens in them sometimes. And second, I think that the emphasis on Benghazi has been extremely political, partly because Fox was operating as a wing of the Republican Party.
All right. Tom Ricks, thanks very much for joining us today.
You're welcome.
Fox abruptly ended that interview. You saw that after a mere 90 seconds. But Ricks did not back down. Listen to his reaction when the Huffington Post reads him Fox's public statement after that interview. It's really more of a public smackdown. Listen.
Here we have a statement from Michael Clemente, the executive VP of News Editorial at Fox News Channel. He said, when Mr. Ricks ignored the anchor's question, it became clear that his goal was to bring attention to himself and his book. He apologized in our offices afterward, but doesn't have the strength of character to do that publicly. Your reaction?
That's horrible.
All right, then. Howie Kurtz from The Daily Beast and CNN's Reliable Sources is here with us. So Ricks has become the star du jour. His appearance on Fox News has hundreds of thousands of views on YouTube. Some say he planned this whole thing. I mean, was this his I'm mad as hell moment?
I don't think Tom Ricks planned anything, but he did take quite a provocative swipe at Fox News. The reason this has gone viral, the reason for all the YouTube attention, the reason we're still talking about it, is because the Fox anchor, John Scott, you know, gave him the hook because he dared to criticize Fox's coverage of the Libya situation that was deemed unacceptable. And in effect, he was tossed off the air.
Well, it would have been such an interesting conversation. So I'm wondering, like, if he said a similar thing on CNN, I'd talk to him about it.
This is exactly the point that I've been trying to make. And I put this to Fox News, and Michael Clemente, the executive vice president mentioned earlier, said, well, that's not John Scott's style, and maybe he should have. But he was offended that Ricks seemed to be calling attention to himself. Imagine a guest coming on TV, the book, calling attention to himself. What really happened here is that Fox, I guess like a lot of news organizations, doesn't like to be criticized. But this could have been a really interesting, provocative discussion if Ricks takes the position that the whole coverage of Benghazi, while obviously it's a serious and legitimate issue with four American diplomats dead, has been hyped for political reasons by Fox News. Certainly the anchor could have pushed back on that. Instead, by cutting the interview short, Fox sent the signal, I believe, that it's kind of defensive and thin-skinned when it comes to criticism, even though, as you know, journalists love to criticize everybody else.